Salatu wassalamu ala nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi wa azwajihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd, fa'audhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Rabbishrah li sadri wa yassir li amri ahlul uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. Rabbi zidni ilman ajma'in inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase in all of us knowledge. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brothers and sisters, we did a little bit of inna last time. In our last session, we'll do it again, inshallah. Inshallah, you will understand it fully. Why I say this? Because I have confidence that you understood the concept of Jumla Ismiya very well. In Jumla Ismiya, we always look for Mubtada and Khabar. Now, as we know, Khabar can be of five kinds. So I have written five sentences here. Okay, brothers and sisters. In fact, there are six sentences, but the last two sentences are for Jumla Ismiya. So, brothers and sisters, we must always remember, whenever the Khabar, the word khabar will come, it can be of five kinds. Later on we will have khabar kana, khabar laisa, khabar mahijaziya. All these things will come. But if you know the concept very well, that the khabar can be of five kinds, things become very easy. You know? So here we are, brothers and sisters. Khabar can be one word. Al-kitabu jadidun. So when it is one word, it is always marfu. Al-kitabu jadidun. Or it can come, the khabar can come as a mudaf and there will be mudaf ilayhi. Al Quranu kitabullahi. Are you with me? I'm not writing, but you know this sentence very well. Al Quranu mubtada. Where is the news? Kitabullahi. So kitabullahi is mudaf mudaf ilayhi. But where is our khabar? Kitab. Because there is the marfu. So it is one word. Then we will say huwa mudaf and Allahi mudaf ilayhi. Very simple word. Remember this word. Al-Quranu kitabullahi or Muhammadun Rasulullahi. So Rasulullahi is again mudaf mudaf ilayhi. So our khabar is Rasul only. Fine. But then we come to Al-Kitabu. Okay. It's Mubtada. What is the news? Alal Maktabi. What is Alal Maktabi? Jar Majrur, Shubu Jumla, Khabar. MashaAllah. And then we say, Al Kitabu Mubtada. What is the news? Tahta Al Kursiyi. So Tahta is Zarf. So we say Tahta Zarf, and immediately we say Shubu Jumla, Khabar. And then what about the next noun? Al Kursiyi Mudaf Ilayhi. Khalas. Simple, brother. Then we say Hamidun. Okay, very good. Mubtada. What is the news? Zahaba ila al-masjidi. So Zahaba ila al-masjidi is a complete jumla filia, verbal sentence. What do we look in verbal sentence? We are looking for fi'l and fa'il. So what is, where is our fi'l? Zahaba. Where is our fa'il? Mustatir. In this case, mustatir. Okay. And what is ila al-masjidi? Jar majrur. Khalas. Now we say Hamidun. Okay. Fine. Mubtada. Where is the news? The news comes in the form of a complete jumla ismiya. Lahu salasatu abna'in. How will you translate Lahu salasatu abna'in? He has three sons. Okay, brother? Three sons. So, Lahu, what is Lahu? Jar majrur. Are you with me? Jar majrur. Now it is in the front. Shubu jumla khabar. And then salasatu abna'in. What is salasatu abna'in? It's mudaf, mudaf ilayhi. But first, we are looking for mubtada. So where is mubtada? Mubtada is salasatu. Are you with me? Wahuwa mudaf and then mudaf ilayhi. Fine. So this whole sentence, brother, this whole sentence, what is this whole sentence? Al-Jumlatul Ismiyatu coming as a khabar. Another example of Jumla Ismiya. Hamidun, fine, Hamidun. What is the news about him? It's Mubtada. Hamidun, Mubtada. Hamidun, Mubtada. Brothers and sisters, what is Hamidun? Mubtada. Where is the news? What is the news? His brother is a doctor. What is the news? His brother is a doctor. So, Akhuhu, Tabibun. What is Akhuhu, brothers? Akhuhu is Akhuhu, Mudaf, Mudaf ilayhi. But first we got to find the Mubtada. So, Mubtada is Akhu. Wahuwa, Mudaf. And then who? Mudaf ilayhi. Fine. Where is the khabar for Akhu? Tabibun. Now this whole sentence, brother and sister, whole sentence is khabar for Hamid. So then how many kinds of khabar we are now here looking at? Five kinds of khabar. Jadidun, one word, will always be marfu. Alal maktabi, jar majrur, shibu jumla khabar. Tahta kursiyi, tahta. Tahta, zarf. Shibu jumla khabar and kursiyi mudaf ilayhi. Sahi. And then we have Hamidun Mubtada Zahaba ilal masjidi jumla failure coming as a khabar. And then we have Hamidun Mubtada. What is the news? Lahu salasatu abna'in. He has three sons. So he has three sons. Lahu salasatu abna'in is a complete sentence. Is coming as a khabar for Hamid. Lahu جار مجرور شبو جملہ خبر ثلاثة مبتدا وهو مضاف ان ابنائن مضاف الیہ. Another example for جملہ اسمیہ, because this is where most of the students sometimes get confused because they see there are two مبتداس. But we have to divide the sentence. Brother. حامدون مبتدا. Okay? If you want to say this as a مبتدا number one, that is also fine. And then أخوه طبيب. أخوه is مضاف مضاف إليه. So the translation is his brother is a doctor. So أخو is our مبتدا. You want to call it مبتدا number two, you can call it مبتدا number two. أخوه مبتدا. أخو مبتدا وهو مضاف. هو مضاف إليه. And طبيب is the خبر. We can call it خبر number two for مبتدا number two. And it's all sentence, brothers and sisters. The whole sentence أخوه طبيب is your خبر for مبتدا number one. So we can call it the whole sentence as خبر number one. Keep this in mind, brothers and sisters. Now what إنّا does, Inna enters Jumla Ismiya. And when Inna comes in Jumla Ismiya, brothers and sisters, it gives Mubtada a Nasab. It will give, make Mubtada Mansub. And then once you make Mubtada Mansub, it is no longer Mubtada. It becomes Ismu Inna. What does it become? Ismu inna. So if there is a ismu inna, there will be khabar inna. So it becomes very easy if the first concept of khabar coming in five different forms is strong in our understanding, brother. Then things will become very easy, inshallah. Okay. And as you know, we can also with a inna join our pronoun. So when you join pronoun with inna, brothers and sisters, because inna gives nasab, makes it mansub, the ism, then the pronoun now becomes mansub. Are you with me? If you say innahu, so what is inna? Harfu tawqid wa nasbin. Remember we said that. Harfu tawqid wa nasbin. Okay? For example, I will write down here. Hamidun Talibun. Sahih, brothers and sisters? What is Hamid? Mubtada. What is this, brother? Khabar. Okay? Now I say, Inna Hamidan. Then Talibun will remain Talibun. Okay, brother? So inna brother is harfu taqid, harfu taqid wa nasbin. Tawheedin wa nasbin. Sahi? Inna. And what will become to Hamidin is Ismu Inna. Are you with me? It is Ismu Inna. And then this is will become Khabar Inna. So it is very, very easy, brother. Ismu Inna and Khabar Inna. Now I change this into Huwa Talibun. Huh, brothers and sisters? Huwa talibun. So what is huwa? Mubtada. And what is talibun? Khabar. Are you with me? Now I use inna. So what will you I say? Innahu talibun. Brothers and sisters, so what is inna? Harfu Tawqeedin wa nasbin Are you with me, brother? What is who now? I will say who is ismu inna mansubun. Ismu inna mansubun. Huh? Always, brothers, ismu inna mansub. And what is this? Khabar inna. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? Inshallah. Now we will go to the lesson and read it. Huh? Okay. If you wish to write it down, write it down. Huh? Strong in our 14 pronouns. So if I say innahu, can I do the rest of it? We start again with innahu. Innahu, innahuma, innahum, innaha, innahuma, innahunna, innaka, innakuma, innakum, innaki, innakuma, innakunna, inni, inna, inni, inna. Are you with me, brother and sister? So all these pronouns, because they were joined with inna, they became ismu inna, and they are now mansub. Huh? They are now mansub, huh? Because they join inna, and inna will make it mansub, you know. Its ism will be made mansub. Fine. Now we start the lesson. Hashimun, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Hashim is saying to the teacher, Kaifa haluka ya ustad? La laka bi khair. How are you, ya ustad? Hope you are well. Now, la Allah is also sister of in. Okay? There are several sisters of inna, brothers and sisters. And la Allah is one of them. So all these sisters will behave exactly as the inna behaves. So when you say la'allaka, la'allaka, what is ka? Ismu la'alla mansub. We will say ismu la'alla mansub. Okay. Now we need khabar. Khabar is of five kinds. So what kind of a khabar is here? Bi khairin. What is bi khairin? Shubu jumla khabar. Jar majroor, shubu jumla khabar. Sahi? Very easy, brothers and sisters. It's extremely easy. Okay. Now, again, since we are doing la'alla, let us see if we can conjugate la'alla with all the pronouns. Ready? La'allahu, la'allahuma, la'allahum, la'allaha, la'allahuma, la'allahunna, la'allaka, la'allakuma, la'allakum, la'allaki, la'allakuma, la'allakunna, la'alli. What is it? La'alli. And then la'allana, la'allana. Now, by doing this exercise, brother, okay, we make our understanding of pronouns strong, and when the real exercise will come, you will find it. What will you find there, brother? In the exercise, you will find halwa puri. Because they will be very easy, inshallah. And it is coming. It is coming. Mudars is replying, brothers and sisters. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdu mubtada lillah jar majrur shubu jumla khabar. We know that. Wa kaifa haluka anta ya Hashim. Now, brother, anta is used here for emphasize. If you don't use it, the sentence is still correct. Kaifa haluka ya Hashim, that is also correct. And when you say kaifa haluka anta, you are just emphasizing, you know. Fine. Ana uhibbuka kathiran. Ana mubtada. Uhibbuka is a jumla failure. We have not learned this. And ka is an object of ohebu, which is in Arabic mafulun bihi. Ohebu, I love. Whom do you love? Ka, I love you. Okay. And what is kathiran, brother and sister? Kathiran is mafulun mutlak. We are going to learn later on, inshallah. Innaka, see, now comes innaka. So what will you say, brother Hassan? Inna is arfu taqid wa nasbin. And what is ka? Ismu inna mansub. Sahi? What will you say ka? Ismu inna mansub. Where is the khabar? Talibun is your khabar. One word. Okay, then after talibun comes zakiyun. What is zakiyun? Brother Abdul Samad, it is a naat, talibun zakiyun. Now comes mujtahidun, also naat. But these are all mautufun ala zaki. Okay. And then wazu. Now zu is also a naat. And it is mautufun ala zakiyun. And then wahuwa mudaf. And then mudaf ilayhi. Brothers and sisters, I told you that we have so far studied Ayyu, and then we studied Kullu. Now we are studying Zu. They will come as a Mudaf. Now there will be Mudaf Ilayhi. Are you with me? There will be mudafili. Now the tricky thing is, if you really want to understand well, and I always felt that I should understand well, you know, when I was studying. I want to know everything, even though it is hard. You have to watch that zu, which is a mudaf, can come as a naat or can come as a khabar also. It will come as a khabar or it can come as a naat. Doesn't matter, whatever way it comes, it will always have mudaf ilayhi. Because it has mudaf ilayhi. Whether it comes as a khabar or whether it comes as a naat, it will have mudaf ilayhi. So look at this sentence, brother. There is a beautiful exercise coming. Now, this requires a little bit of understanding and a little bit of extra penetrating. Okay. Now look at here. We already got talibun as a khabar. Then zakiyun came as a naat. And then mujtahidun also is a naat, but mautufun ala zakiyun. Then again ataf came. Again zu is a naat, but it is mautufun ala zakiyun. So it is our naat. Now there will be sentences in which it will become khabar. And we have to watch. We have to watch. Zu khulqin. Zu means owner or possessor. Brother? Literal meaning is owner or possessor. When you say ذو خلق means he has good character, with a good character. There are things that will surprise you when you understand ذو very well. Because you always say, Ya ذل جلالي والإكرام. So what is this Ya ذل جلالي? What is this? ذو became ذا. Zu became za. All these things we will study and it will surprise you, brother. That these things we used to say it all the time but never understood the meaning of or the construction of it. Fine, brothers and sisters. Amin Pakistan anta, am min al Hindi. No, I want you to really underline min Pakistan and I want you to underline min al Hindi, brothers and sisters. Okay, this is also a concept That has to be understood. What is A, brother? A is called Harfu Istifham. Brother Abdul Samad, A is for asking question. And what is Am? Am means or. Am, there is another word, Av. They both mean or. Now we have to remember one thing, that am is only used in questions. And av is used in statements. Statement. When you use a question and you have to use or, then you will use am. When you have to say a statement and use or, you will use av. So what is so special about this? I want to explain, brother. Am in Pakistan, anta. Am min al Hindi. In a sentence, when you are not sure and you ask a question and you state two things. How many things? Two things. Okay. This or that. Because you're not sure. So in Arabic language, brother, the two things that you want to inquire about, first thing will come after A. Are you with me? Here is, brother, I'm not too sure whether he's from Min Pakistan. And the other thing is, Minal Hindi. I'm not too sure. Okay. Are there two things that you are inquiring? Then immediately after A, one will come. Are you with me? So immediately after A, I say A, Min, Bakis, Tana, and then Anta. Am, then the second thing. Number one I'm inquiring about, and number two. And there are two things. One and two. Are you with me? How will you say in English? Are you from Pakistan or Pakistan or from India? See, these things came together and in the middle is or. Sahi? Are you from Pakistan or India? Okay? They came together with the or dividing them. Can I say the same thing in Arabic? Anta min Pakistan am min al Hindi? I can say that, you know. Anta min Pakistan am min al Hindi? But that will be wrong. That will be very poor Arabic. The eloquent Arabic will be that we divide those two things, we bring one soon after A and the other thing after am. Are you following me, brother? Is this clear? Instead of saying anta, no, I don't say anta. I bring that one thing. Amin Pakistana Anta. Amin Pakistana Anta. Am min al Hindi. That will be a most correct form. You have to remember this. This is how when you ask about two things, then this is the way you will say it. Now, here is, I don't know whether this thing is a masjid or a school. They both look same. So I say, Ahada masjidun am madrasatun, but that will be incorrect. A masjidun haza. A madrasatun. Am madrasatun. Are you with me? A masjidun haza. Am madrasatun. I write down this sentence. Two things, brother. A masjidun haza. And then I'm writing here, Am Madrasatun. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? Let me write down with this black. What will you say in English? Is this a masjid? Or a school. So masjid or a school came together. But in Arabic, a masjidun haza. Not a haza masjidun. You will say a masjidun haza am madrasatun. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? Write down these two. They are coming in a lesson. There is a whole exercise coming to tell us. Now this is the eloquent way of saying it. If you say it the other way, ahada masjidun am madrasatun, it's a very poor Arabic. A person will understand you, but that is not correct. That is incorrect. You will say, a masjidun haza am madrasatun. So similarly here, we don't know whether he's from Pakistan or from India. So we are asking, am min Pakistan anta am min al Hindi. That is the correct way of asking. Inshallah, you will remember, brothers and sisters, you will read this lesson. I used to read book 2 often, brother, because the lessons are beautiful and they are beautiful dialogues. So one can enjoy reading them over and over again, brothers and sisters. What is the answer of Hashim? Inni min al Hindi. Now what is inni? How many words are there? There are two words, brothers and sisters. Okay? What is it? Sister Sukhaina, inna and plus ya mutakallim. Sister Hafza, did you get it? Inni is two words. Inna plus ya mutakallim. So inna, what is inna? Harfu taqid wa nasb. And what is ya mutakallim, Sister Hafza? Ismu inna. Mansubun, mashallah. May Allah bless you, sister, and all of us. Mashallah, mashallah. Very good. And then where is our khabar, Sister Hafza? Min al-Hindi. What is min al-Hindi? Jar marjur shubu jumla khabar. Mashallah. That's the way it is. Aha, aha. I like it. Okay. Wa zamiluka. وَزَمِلُكَ الَّذِي خَرَجَ مَاكَ الْآنَ مِنَ الْفَصْلِ. Brother, only translate this. Do not try to analyze it. Because questions we don't analyze. وَزَمِلُكَ الَّذِي خَرَجَ مَاكَ الْآنَ مِنَ الْفَصْلِ. How will you translate, Brother Abdul Samad? So this is the translation. And your colleague, who came out with you now from the class, Ahuwa Aidan, is he also من الهندي. What is the answer? لا. إنه من باكستان. See how cleverly Dr. Saab is using those pronouns in the dialogue, and we are getting the practice of all our pronouns, you know. Dr. Saab will use all the pronouns except dual. He will not use dual now till the end of the book. But for the sake of practice and simplicity and the sequence, when we practice, we do 14 in a sequence, brother. Okay. Innahu min Pakistan. Inna Sumaya. What is inna? Harfu taqid wa nasb. What is who? Ismu inna mansub. Mashallah. And where is khabar inna? Min Pakistan. What is min Pakistan, sister? Jar majrur, shubu jumla khabar. Inshallah, I'm going to ask everyone. And inshallah, you'll try to answer me. If you get confused, don't worry, it's normal. But I would like you to make an attempt, and inshallah, you'll become strong. Now, Al Mudaris is saying, what is he saying? Inna. After inna, there is no pronoun, but a noun is coming. So, inna will make that noun mansub. And we will call that noun ismu inna. So what is inna sa'ata? It is sa'atu. Sa'atu became sa'ata. Now that is our ismu inna. Wahuwa mudaf. And what is ka? Mudafili. Inna sa'ataka. Jamilatun. Okay, Sister Fatima, what is jamilatun? Jamilatun, it's one word. So it is a khabar inna. What is it? Khabar inna. We got our ismu inna sa'ata. Wahuwa mudaf, mudaf ilahi. Min al yabani hiya. See, this is the proper way of saying. If you say, ahiya min al yabani, it's not right. Min al yabani hiya. Are you with me? Min al yabani hiya. What is the answer? La. And then, innaha. Sister Fatima, what is inna? Harfu tawqid wa nasb. And what is ha? Ismu inna mansubun. Got your ismu inna? And where is your khabar inna? Min al hindi. What is it? Jar majur, shubu jumla khabar. MashaAllah. Now see how the question is asked. You are asking, you don't know whether it is cheap or expensive. In English, you will say, is it cheap? Is it inexpensive or expensive? Inexpensive or expensive will come together in English. But in Arabic, we will say, Aghaliyatun hiya. What will you say in Arabic, brother? Aghaliyatun hiya. Am rakhisatun. So here comes a and am. Now we cannot say a hiya. No, we will say a ghaliyatun hiya. Am rakhisatun. Got the idea? Watch for this construction, brother and sister. A ghaliyatun hiya. Am rakhisatun. So between a and am, the two things that we are inquiring, one will come immediately after a. And then the other thing will come after am, and everything else in between. This construction is very important to keep it in mind. Inshallah. Innaha rakhisatun jiddan. Innaha rakhisatun jiddan. See, rakhisatun. Tun. Okay. Marfu. Okay, so Sister Naima, what is innaha? How many words are there? Two. What is inna? Harfu taqid wa nasbin. And what is ha? Ismu inna mansu. And what is, where is our khabar? Rakhisa tun. That is your khabar, one word, marfu. And what is jiddan? Jiddan is jiddan, marfu, mansub, majroor. Mansub, it is Mansub. So there it is something else. And it is Maf'ulun Mutlaq. We will read it and understand it later on. Huh? Don't worry. I will be saying Maf'ulun Mutlaq so many times, you will become expert in saying Maf'ulun Mutlaq. And you will even figure out that it is Maf'ulun Mutlaq. The only thing you won't know is why. And that we will learn later on in book 3. Okay, brothers and sisters. Innaha, sister Faiza, innaha bi miyati rubiyatin fakat. Now, brother and sisters, the word fakat means only. It's a very common word, fakat. It has never been used in Quran. Fakat has never come in Quran. Okay? But we use fakat all the time in our conversation. And keep that in mind, brother. So, sister Faiza, innaha, how many words are there? Two. What are they? Inna, mashallah, ismo inna, mansub. You will always say mansub because we want to have that idea of mansub in our mind. How is ismo inna mansub? No, where is our khabar? What is B? Miyati. B, Miyati. Huh? B, what is B? Harfchar. So Miyati became Isam Majrur. Harfchar, Isam Majrur. So this B, Miyati, brothers and sisters, is your Jar Majrur, Shibu Jumla Khabar. And what is Rubiyatin? See, B, Miyati, with single Kasra. Now Rubiyatin came with a Tanween Kasra. Can you figure out? Brothers and sisters, Rubiyatin is Mudaf ilayhi.